Are you looking for a low-code way to take advantage of the agents revolution? Well, join us in this next episode of the Cozy AI Kitchen. I'm sure you've heard of AutoGen, the coding framework to create complex and powerful multi-agent systems. Well, if you don't code all the time, you're in luck because there is a low-code way to do it called AutoGen Studio. We have the designer of that system right here in the Cozy AI Kitchen. Welcome, Jingya Chen. Hi, Jingya.
Hi, John. Nice to meet you. Hi, everyone.
Thanks for coming.
Yeah, I'm excited to be here.
So as a designer, I know that making things complex, simpler isn't an easy task.
Yeah, it's not easy.
So what are a few secrets, you think, to tell the audience?
Yeah, I think, first of all, it's still like putting user at the first and trying to help user coordinate with the user to build a easy user mental model of like building this complex multi-agent system, break it down to some smaller and manageable components. I think it's a key.
Just like a good agent, focus.
Yes.
Okay, great. Well, we would love to have you cook with AutoGen Studio.
Yes.
This is so exciting.
Yes.
When I saw the design for this, I was really blown away and I was like, we'd love to share it with the audience. So thank you for doing this.
Yeah, I'm also excited to show this demo. So for now, I will kind of skip the installation part because you can always find it on AutoGen website. It's pretty easy. I would say it's not like an online web link. It's more like a code report of part of the AutoGen, and you can easily download it and install it and run your local machine. And here I already installed it. So to have a great demo, I will take an example. For example, we are trying to build a multi-agent system, which is a book generation. So the user can use this multi-agent system to generate a book with text and image. So let's take this as an example.
Okay.
So now when you open the current AutoGen Studio interface, you can see we have the build and playground section. Let's start with the build. And on the build page, you can see there are major like four different entities.
It's very simple to use, I noticed.
Yes.
Nice design.
Thank you. We try to make it pretty simple and direct. Yes. So the workflow is where we connect all different agents together to make a multi-agent system. And the skill, model, and agents are all the ingredients to cook a workflow, which is really aligned with our kitchen, cozy kitchen idea.
You're cooking right here.
Yes. And so let's take a look at the skill first. So skills are essentially just some Python functions, and you can use to do some like simple tasks like generate image, like for example, save as PDF or web search or like fetch a profile. So let's take a look.
Wow, you have the code and the low code connected.
Yes,
cool.
That is another part I want to mention for the design challenge is because AutoGen itself is a code-first framework. So how can we balance the simplicity of graphic UI and the complexity of using code? So that's a challenge. So we kind of take a hybrid approach here. Yeah. So whatever like function you want to create here, you can write it here or you can like write somewhere else or paste it here. So for example, this is a generating image. So basically it's just make a call to the OpenAI like service, like for example, the DALL-E. And then if after you generate image, you will save these files to your disk. And for example, you can give a name, description, and add your like API key here.
Yep.
Yeah, and similarly, this just a function to save on the output as a PDF, and you can always create new skills. We have like a template here, but you can like delete that and create your own.
It's multimodal.
You
can do different kind of media and text. Cool.
Yes. So after the skill, I would like to introduce the model, which is most exciting because we're introducing LLM here.
Yeah,
so let's see, we create a new model here.
Oh.
So we can see we support different types of model, like any endpoint is compatible
That's
with OpenAI or Azure OpenAI or even Gemini. And in the future, we want to support more customized, like smaller models.
Right.
Yes. So in different model types, you have different settings. Of course, you need to input your API key and other things. And for example, the AutoGen Studio will detect itself whether you already input your API key.
Yep.
So for now, I already have it in other model.
It'll store it for you.
Yes, I don't have to input it here again. And we have something like test model here. Okay, it's successfully tested.
I love the test button.
Yes.
Because you're not sure.
That's exactly. So I think that's also another element I learned in this design process is we should provide individual test.
Right. It's like knocking on the door of the model. Are you there?
Yes, yes. This could happen in skills and agent as well. We shouldn't wait until you finish the whole multi-agent and then test.
Oh, I love that.
Yes. And we can save this model. And then we go to agent. So for example, we can also create a new agent. Here is some fun things. We have like different agent types. And I have to say that the code framework has more like diverse agent types, but for the local version, we select like mostly common use types for the user to start with. So for example,
I gotta tell you, having worked in code with AutoGen, you're making it all so much more, so much easier to use, but also your kitchen is so well organized.
Thank you.
And exactly where everything is in the kitchen.
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah. So for example, for the user proxy, it's a really common agent in AutoGen, which is directly communicate with the user and also execute the code. And assistant agent is where the major agent who will produce like the major task plans and all the code plans. And group chat is even more, a little bit more complex because you can contain multiple agents inside a group chat. It's similar to our like day-to-day group chat. We will have a group chat manager and he or she will assign a task to different agent to perform a more complex workflow. So for example, let's take a look at the user proxy. You can give a name, description, for example, the reply, max number, and the human input mode. This is something also really interesting because as we always want the agent to be autonomous enough, we don't want the human to interrupt in the process. But in some cases, user also want the human to provide feedback and to decide whether to move forward, then you can switch it to always.
This is often called human in the loop.
Yes, right? Exactly. So depending on how much you want the human in the loop. Yes. So, and you can also change the system message, and we have some more advanced options here. And like, for example, for the user proxy, we have the code execution. And if we create a like a assistant agent, so for now, because we are generating a book, so we can call it like book creating assistant. And it's like creating a book. Yes, let's do it. And then we have some default system message here, but you can definitely modify it.
System prompt.
Yes, exactly. And beside the system prompt, actually, the agent description will also influence how you want to perform the task. But I will just keep it simple here.
Got it. A little bit of extra information to guide it.
Exactly. So let's create this agent. Okay, it's successfully created. And now you will find we have two other tabs where we can use previous ingredients here.
Understand.
So when you add a new model, we can use the one we just created. And the skill, we can add a predefined skill like create image, create PDF, And now we...
You're giving the tools to the agent.
Exactly, giving a model and giving the tools. Yeah. And sometimes you don't need a tool, but sometimes you might want.
Sure.
Yeah, so now we have the agent ready.
Okay.
Now, exciting part is here. We go to the workflow to connect all the things together.
Okay, this is where it happens.
Yes, let's click create new workflow. And here we also have two templates.
Wow, that's so beautiful and easy to understand.
Thank you. Yeah. Uh-huh. So we have like two typical like workflow type. One is autonomous and another is sequential. Mm-hmm. Autonomous is most frequently used by our user because we don't need to worry about when which agent take which like task and how they take turns. We just leave to all the agent to decide. Okay. But sequential is sometimes the user want the agent to perform the task in certain order. For example, the first agent pass the summary result to the next agent. And I want to define that like that way. But now we can just use this one to make our life easier. So we can give a name like book creation workflow. And the summary method means because it's not like a single agent conversation, we can directly talk to one agent per time. It's more like a lot of agents, they talk by themselves. So there will be a conversation history. And when they turn the result back to the user, we kind of need a summary. So we can use a LM to summarize that for us, or we can use like the last message, or we don't want it.
Because the chat history gets long.
Yes, pretty long. We can see it later. Mm-hmm. So now we create this workflow, and then we can add agents. Mm. So for the autonomous one, we always have a sender. Usually it's a user proxy. Mm-hmm. And then a receiver, we can use the one we just create called book creating.
Mm. The initiator kicks it off.
Yes.
I see.
Yes, it will kick off the conversation. Mm. And then it will hand off to the receiver. And the receiver can be more complex like group chat.
Right.
And there are more than one agent.
Okay, wow.
Yes. Mm. And now we have this workflow.
Yep.
And we can test it quickly here.
Love the test button.
Yes. But I think this is pretty similar in the playground, so I will show you there. Mm-hmm. So in the playground, we have some old sessions, and we can generate a new.
Yep.
And we can select which workflow you want to use here. So we can use the one we've just created.
So it already ran it?
Yes.
Oh, wow. That was fast.
Yes. Let's do a quick test. For example, let's create a book. Create a PDF book because we have that function.
The tool, wow.
Yeah, book with 3 pages, like, let's see. And on each page contains text and image and about maybe, let's make it cute, fairy tale. In Seattle forest.
Okay, gonna have a lot of mushrooms in there.
Yeah, I like mushrooms and fairies. Let's see how it works. It might take some time because it involves
it's doing
image.
All of that.
Yes.
And you just sort of set up the recipe, you got it going in a workflow, and you're saying out from this, your kitchen is gonna come a PDF with 3 pages.
Yes.
Wow. It's exciting. It's like waiting for the souffle to rise.
Yes, exactly. Very similar.
It may rise, it may fall, we don't know, but so like when you think about the design of taking a very high code thing and low code, I think you did a phenomenal job. So you were saying you were start from the user, breaking the smaller tasks, and here we are. Well, something has come
up. Yeah, let's see. Mm. So as we can see, this is a summarized part.
Yep.
What we select is use LM to summarize all the things it does.
Uh-huh.
And some interesting thing is, okay, let's take a look at the result first. This is a PDF. Okay.
The moment.
Yeah. Let's see.
It's coming. Wow. Anticipation. What's going to appear?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm excited about this.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Look at that.
We got that.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, we have like a small story.
Oh, look at that. Oh, it's like a movie.
Yeah, it's like a movie scene.
Wow, the hidden cottage. Oh, exciting. Wow, this is very inspiring. And
yeah,
all
that's
because you were able to work well with the agent using AutoGen Studio like this, and you really, there was no code you had to write.
Yes, exactly.
Low code.
Yes.
No code.
Yeah.
Right.
And there is one interesting thing here is we can observe what happens between all these agents.
Interesting.
So we can see at first user proxy help us to convey our request to the book creating assistant.
Yep.
And book creating assistant got a lot to do. It has the plan how it will generate the book and the PDF, and it produced code here.
Wrote code to help itself.
Yes, like it has a structure of this book here, and then it sends to the user proxy to execute the code.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, you can see there is a code output here as PDF, and then on the book creating assistant will save all this document to our disk. So it's a pretty clear process. And also, we can also click the profiler.
Whoa, that's cool.
Yes, to check how much I cost.
That's beautiful. Everyone wants to know, only 9 cents.
I got a book.
Wow.
Yes, it's fun, right?
Wow, this has been truly magical. Jingya, okay,
thank
I'm a little
you.
Blown away. Everyone watching this, just I'm sure you had this moment like, what? So Jingya, when you think about designers out there like yourself who really have mastered, I mean, to do this, you have to understand the code and processes to some extent. So do you have any advice for designers out there to somebody become like you as a designer of AI?
Yes, I do have a lot of learnings on designing this product. One thing I think I'm lucky because AutoGen itself as a code framework, even before the studio comes out, we already have a really large and active community. So I kind of gathering a lot of needs and like requirements from the audience that they really want a low code version.
Wow.
Yes. So I kind of gather a lot of user input at the beginning before I started this work, which can help me to better understand the user mental model, the user need, and what's their like typical workflow. So this definitely helped me a lot to design this like a simpler version of AutoGen. And another thing is definitely communicate a lot with our amazing engineering group because they are not only the developer of this tool, but they are also like target audience of this tool. So I can also learn what their thinking is from there. And I think one interesting thing I found in this process is when we start to building AutoGen Studio, we kind of want to make it facing broader audience. With like limited like coding experience, or they just want to build it from like a really graphic user interface. But besides this type of user, we also see like AutoGen Studio help a lot of developers to lower the entry barrier. So there is something interesting I want to show you here is in the workflow. So we build this one and we test it. We're kind of satisfied, so we can download it. So when we click download, it's well downloaded, and you can also export it.
Wow.
Yeah, so when you export this, you can export this whole workflow as a JSON file.
I can reuse it.
Yes, you can use it anywhere in your own code, your own project.
Oh. Well, Jingya, I'm so glad you came to show this because for those of you who are struggling to understand agents, even if you're a developer, this is a fantastic way to get started. Well, Jingya, thank you very much. And audience, I hope you enjoyed how to cook agents with a sophisticated AutoGen Studio. See you later.
See you.